After understanding the structure of the heart, then let's move towards the function of the heart. So how the heart is pumping the blood to all over the body and towards the lungs. So stepwise let's discuss. So first what happened? The deoxygenated blood from all over the body through the vena cava, it is coming towards the heart. And the impure blood or deoxygenated blood is drained out in the right auricle or right atrium. Okay, so what we discussed that first of all, from the all over the body, the deoxygenated blood is coming through the vena cava, superior and inferior, and into which part it is moving? It is moving towards the right atrium or right auricle, okay, upper part of the heart. Then just simultaneously here what happened, that next neighboring part or the left auricle, it is receiving blood, which blood? Oxygenated blood from the lungs. So at a time, both the parts of the upper side of the heart, means both the auricles are receiving the blood. Right side impure blood, left side pure blood. So during this phase, the heartbeat starts. Next step, what happened? Now the atria or the auricle now filled up with the blood, right side having the deoxygenated blood and left side having the oxygenated blood. Now they are going for a contraction phase, means now the atria, they contract and the valves open to allow the blood into the ventricle. So now you just analyze that blood is entering into the auricles, right and left. After that, the auricles, they contract, squeezed, and the blood, it is forced towards the ventricle. So how the blood will enter into the ventricle? Because the valves are open. Which valves? Right side having the tricuspid valve and left side having the bicuspid valve. So when the impure blood is moving from the right auricle to right ventricle, tricuspid valve is open and it is allowing the blood to flow into the right ventricle. Just pause it. When the pure blood is flowing from left auricle to or atria towards the left ventricle, the bicuspid valve opens and it is allowing the blood to flow into the ventricle. Then when the ventricles, they are filled up with the blood, then it's time for the contraction of the ventricle. The ventricle contracts and they force the blood to move away from the heart. So where they will go? Now just remember, the ventricles, they are having the thicker wall because they are have to pumping the blood, they have to pump the blood, and the auricle have thinner wall as compared to the ventricle because they are only receiving the blood. So now both the ventricle, they contract, and from the right side through the pulmonary artery, impure or deoxygenated blood will move toward the lungs. Heart will pump the impure blood towards the lungs. And from the left side or left ventricle, blood is pushed through the aorta to all over the body. So like this, one cycle it is completed. Then again the cycle repeat. It means which cycle? First the entrance of impure blood, then next the entrance of the pure blood. Again the blood is moving towards the whole body. From the body blood is coming, then again it is moving to the lungs, from lungs it is coming back to the heart, and from the heart again it is moving to the whole body part. So this is a cyclic event and it is called as the cardiac cycle. So in one cycle, just observe, two times blood is moving through the heart, once in pure form and once in impure form. So two cycles are there, in two that cycle is there once when the blood is circulating, means twice the blood is entering into the heart. So that is called the double circulation. So blood goes here two times through the heart in one cycle. In one cycle, blood is moving twice through the heart. So that is called the double circulation. Students, I am repeating this one again and again because this is a very important question. You are getting a definition based question here. So whenever double circulation is there, let's observe more about this. Here two types of circulations are going on. As we discussed, once blood is entering into the heart pure form, once in impure form. So how this process is going on? So here in double circulation, it is classified into two parts. One is called the pulmonary circulation, another is called the systemic circulation. So what is that pulmonary and systemic circulation? Let's see. So before that, we must know the definition. When one cycle of blood circulation is completed, a fixed quantity of blood flows through the heart twice, called double circulation. Or simply you can write like this: in one cycle, when blood moves twice through the heart, that is called the double circulation. So what is pulmonary circulation? Pulmonary means here the lungs is involved. So when the impure blood is entering into the heart, and from the heart the impure blood is supplied to the lungs, again from the lungs it is coming back to the heart. So this cyclic event from heart to lungs and lungs to heart, maybe it is shortest pathway, but it is also maintaining a cycle, heart to lungs and lungs to heart. So this is called the pulmonary circulation. So now let's see the pathway. Impure blood, then it moves to the right atrium. From the right atrium, it is moving towards the right ventricle. How? By opening of the tricuspid valve. Then from the right ventricle, through pulmonary artery, it is moving to the lungs. From the lungs, it is coming back to the left side. Means oxygenated blood, it is coming back to the left atrium. So here the pulmonary circulation completes. It is a short cycle. The next one is the systemic circulation. In pulmonary, shortest path the blood is covering, but here it is covering a very large path. How? Here the pure blood from the heart, it is has to pump towards the all over the body. So firstly, from the lungs, oxygenated blood is entering into the which side of the heart? That is the left atrium. From the left atrium, it is coming towards the left ventricle. How? Here the opening of the mitral or bicuspid valve is there. Then from the ventricle, which ventricle? Left ventricle, through the aorta, the largest artery of the body, through the aorta, blood is pumped to all over the body. So again, when blood is passing through all over the body, again it is deoxygenated and again coming back towards the right side through the vena cava. So what is the path that's traced? Pure blood from the lungs, then it is entering into the left atrium. From the left atrium, left ventricle to aorta, through the aorta, all body tissue. In all body tissue, due to gaseous exchange, impure blood again originated, coming towards the right side by the, which one? By the vena cava. So like that the pathway it is covered. So here we discuss about the two type of circulation. One is the pulmonary circulation and another is the systemic. So just here observe the diagram about the pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation. Now you see pulmonary circulation starts from the right ventricle and ends in the left ventricle. Means from right ventricle, deoxygenated blood is moving throughout the pulmonary artery, then to the lungs, then in lungs oxygenated through the pulmonary vein, it is entering to the left auricle. Like that, systemic circulation begins from the left ventricle, where oxygenated blood is pumped to the aorta. Aorta is giving into the arteries. Arteries, it is taking to all parts of the body. Then when it is taking the blood is deoxygenated, and gradually through the veins it is given to the vena cava. Again, vena cava is bringing the blood to the right auricle. So overall we are getting the double circulation. So in all the organism, double circulation is not there. In some organism, here in case of fish, it is having the single circulation. In a single circulation, when the gaseous exchange takes place, it takes place in the gills. The network of capillaries are there in the gills, there it takes place. And that's why heart only having the role to pump the blood. Means here the deoxygenated blood is collected in the heart. Heart is pumping the blood to the capillaries of gills, and their oxygenation occur, and from the gills only it is supplied to all over the body. It is not coming back again to the heart. Just in human being we have discussed that impure blood is coming to the heart, then from that going to the lungs, again from the lungs it is coming to the heart, and from the heart it is supplied to all over the body. But here the single circulation is there, means blood is moving through the heart once. Then in case of frog, they are having three chambered heart, and in three chambered heart here the double circulation is there, but here is a disadvantage, that is when the blood is coming towards the ventricle, because here the auricles are two but ventricle is one, so that's why right and left ventricles are they are joined. And that's why the mixing of pure and impure blood is there. Maybe double circulation, but they are not getting the pure blood, or it is not circulated all over the body. But in case of human being or mammals, like birds, they are having very highly developed heart. The four chambered heart, and all the chambers are separated from each other. So what is the advantage of the separation of the chambers? When the heart is divided into various chambers, means the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood are separated from each other. When they are separated from each other, they are not mixing. It means the amount of oxygen it is supplied, it is maximum, and which is then helpful in the process of respiration. More oxygen means more energy, and for a higher organism we always need more energy for our more activities. And as well as we can control the body temperature also, because we are the organism, we can control our body temperature with the changing environment. But in lower organism like the amphibians, they are the, like the fishes, they are going for the hibernation because they are unable to control their body temperature. So here question is, what is the advantage of separation of blood, or what is the advantage of the four chambered heart over three chambered heart? So in three chambered heart, ventricle is one, that's why mixing of pure and impure blood is there, and the organism is not getting sufficient amount of oxygen. But when four chambered it is there, all the chambers are separated, and pure and impure, or oxygenated and deoxygenated blood, it is also separated, and hence the organism is getting the sufficient amount of oxygen for getting the energy. So this is about the mechanism of circulation of the blood.